give more protection to women under the new Justinian Code. And she managed to do it by changing so many of the different things. Like, for example, according to Greco-Roman law, there was a concept of paterfamilias. The father of the family was the absolute master, because just wanted to, the father wanted to his wife and children. And Justinian's court, the influence of Theodora, weakened significantly the indiscriminate power of the husband, the father, and the family. Theodora also gave more property rights to women. Women couldn't own land on their own. And he, according to the new law, as influenced by Theodora, he now made it legal for women to own land in their own name. And you know, it wasn't, if a woman inherited the land would really not be owned by her, it would be owned by her husband or her closest male relative in many cases, rather than her. And he changed that law as well, based on Theodora. Also, Theodora was very interested in children's rights. She made it illegal to expose children, unwanted babies. That had been a tradition which was frowned upon but legal until that time. And, you know, today we have something of a revision of that, only because of the new law, for example, in some of the states, allows unwanted infants to survive abortion to be allowed to die. And so this is made illegal by the law based on Theodora's wishes. Also, she made a practice of going, slavery existed in those days. Slavery was not based on race. Any race could be a slave. And there were many girls who were sold into slavery, even by their parents. Parents could sell daughters into slavery. A young daughter, she sent her people around to buy these girls, and then she would free them, provide them education, and provide for their livelihood, see if she can arrange a decent marriage or whatever for these girls.